In this video, we want to show that this set S, which is the set of vectors in R3 that satisfy this equation, we want to show that this set is not a vector space. And now, let's just take a look at this equation. If you take a look at this term is linear in X1. This term here is cubic in X2. And this term is quadratic in X3. So if I scale the original vector by some scalar, then each of these terms will scale by a different factor. So to me, looking at that, that's telling me that closure under scalar multiplication is in danger. It's probably not going to work. So let's actually just show that. Let's take a vector from this set and scale it by a scalar and show it no longer satisfies this equation. Okay, so the vector we're going to take is the vector, let's take the vector 2, 0, 1. Now I claim that this is actually in the set S, but you shouldn't just take my word for it. You should check that this actually does belong to S. So let's test this against the equation. So I'm going to say, I'm claiming that this is in S, and let's see why. So this is in S since 2 times 2 plus 3 times 0 cubed, so second component cubed, minus 4 times 1 squared, or what is that? That's 4 plus 0 minus 4, which is 0. So yes, this vector is in the set S. So let's see what happens when we scale this vector. I'm going to take this vector and I'm going to scale it by 2, and you'll see that I end up with something which isn't in S. So 2 times V, if I double V, we get 2 times 2, 0, 1, which is equal to 4, 0, 2. And I claim that this is not in S. But again, you shouldn't just take my word for that. You should test this. Well, it's not in S since 2 times 4 plus 3 times 0 cubed minus 4 times 2 squared, well, that is 8 plus 0 minus 16, which is minus 8. And minus 8, as we all probably know, is not equal to 0. So 2 times V is not in the set S. It doesn't satisfy this equation. Therefore, S is not closed under multiplication by scalars. So let's write that down. And therefore, it's not a vector space. Because one of these, this is the axiom, well, this is an axiom which is failing. So in this next example, we have a very similar looking set. We have a set of vectors from R3. And again, these vectors satisfy some equation. And we want to do something slightly different. We want to find two non-zero elements from this set S. And we also want to show that this set is not closed under addition. So again, this set's not going to be a vector space because it's not closed under addition. So I'm going to take the vectors 1, 1, 1 and 1, 2, 0, which are both in S. But again, you shouldn't just take my word for that. Let's actually check that these are in the set S. So why are these in S? Well, these are in S since we take this first vector here. Well, since 1 minus 1 times 1 is equal to 0. So it satisfies this equation. And for this second vector, we have 1 minus 2 times 0, which is obviously equal to 0. So we found two non-zero vectors which both sit inside S. And now I'm actually going to use these two vectors to show this second property doesn't hold, that this set is not closed under addition. So let's actually consider what happens when we take the sum of these two vectors. So if we take the sum, so now 1, 1, 1 plus 1, 2, 0, well, that is equal to 2, 3, 1. And this vector here, well, this vector here is not in S. But again, you can't just take my word for that. Let's actually see that this does fail to satisfy that equation. So why is this not in S? Well, this is not in S since 2 minus 3 times 1 is equal to, well, it's equal to minus 1. And minus 1 is not equal to 0. I.e., this vector, 2, 3, 1, is not in S. And that shows what we want. So hence, S is not closed under addition.